Good morning, students. This is my third video of your third chapter, Discovering That Visakha Continues. I'm going to read the lesson for you first and then the explanation. The sun can beat down like a hammer. This far south in Egypt, and Carter tried to use it to loosen the horizon. For several hours, he set the mummy outside in blazing sunlight that heated it to 149 degrees Fahrenheit. Nothing budged. He reported with scientific detachment that the consolidated material had been chiseled away from the beneath of limbs and trunks before it was possible to raise the king's remains. Difficult words of this stanza. Blazing means very hot climate. The sun was very hot. Blood moved or shifted a slight movement. Chilled away to cut something with a chisel. Now the explanation. Carter tried to loosen the horizon by keeping the body in the hot sun. What did this Carter did here? It was impossible to take the body from the box. What he did, he kept it in the hot sunlight so that it would loosen up and it would be easy for them to take it out. He kept the mummy in 149 degrees Fahrenheit heat for several hours, but still it remained stuck. Then too it was so tough that it was still stuck, though it was 149 degrees Fahrenheit temperature. It was so much hotter. He reported that the chisel would be used to cut down the mummy from the limbs and the trunk so that Tut's body would be taken out of the coffin. What he suggested then? He suggested that he must just had a permission to cut the mummy, cut the limbs from the trunk so that the body could be taken out of the coffin. So he said that he must use a chisel to cut it. उन्होंने कहा कि उन्होंने धूप में भी रखी उस कॉफिन को ताकि वो बॉडी और कॉफिन दोनों एक दूसरे से लूज़ हो जाए गर्मी के कारण और निकल जाए, मगर ये पॉसिबल नहीं हुआ. 149 डिग्री फ़ारेनहाइट हीट में बहुत घंटों तक उसे रखा, फिर भी वो उसमें से नहीं निकला. इतना वो ज़्यादा उस पर स्टक हो चुका था. तो फिर उन्होंने कहा कि वो उसे कट करेंगे, वो लिम्स को और वो जो ट्रंक के साथ चिपका हुआ था वो, ताकि वो इजीली कॉफिन में से उसे निकाल सकें उस मम्मी, द किंग्स मम्मी है. इन हिज डिफेंस, कार्टर रियली हैड लिटिल चॉइसेस. इफ ही हैडन कट द मम्मी फ्री, थीव्स मोस्ट सर्टनली वुड हैव circumvented the guards and ripped it apart to remove the gold. In Tut's time, the royals were fabulously wealthy, and they thought or hoped they would take their riches with them. For this journey to the great beyond, King Tut was lavished with glittering golds, precious collars, inlaid necklaces and aprons, bracelets, rings, amulets, sandals, slits for his fingers and toes, and the now iconical inner coffin and mask, all of pure gold, to separate Tut from his adornments. Carter's men removed the mummy's head and served nearly every major point. Once they had finished, they resembled the remains on a layer of a sand in a wooden box with padding that concealed the damage. The bed where Tut now rests. Some difficult words here again. Circumvented, find a way around. Thieves would have found a way to tackle the guards and remove the gold from the tomb. So it was so much tough enough. Stuck very hardly, said no thief can stole the gold which had been kept in the mummy's coffin. Invalid, a decorative pattern of a surface, amulet, ornament or a small piece of jewelry to give protection against evil, danger or diseases. Apron, a protective garment worn over the front of one's clothes laid at the back, tied at the back. Shells a close fitting cover. Iconic, something or someone who is a symbol or it represents some other things here. Adornments, ornaments. Concealed, hide. Now explanation of the paragraph. According to Carter, he had no choices other than to cut the mummy. He had no choice. He was at the last choice to cut the mummy. He believed that if he hadn't done that, thieves would have removed the gold from the tomb and could have looted it. During Tut's time, the royal people were very wealthy and they had a belief that after death they would take the wealth along with them. For his life after death, he was giving precious collars, necklaces with decorative patterns, bracelets, bracelets, rings, amulets, ceremonial aprons, sandals, slits for fingers and toes, and now an iconic inner coffin and a mask. His men removed his head and every joint of his body. After they finished, they resembled the remains in a wooden box with padding filled with a layer of sand to conceal the damage. It was his new resting place of Tut. Now the next paragraph. Archaeology has changed substantially in the intervening decades, focusing less on treasures and more on the fascinating details of life, interweaving mysteries of death. It also uses more sophisticated look, including medical technologies. In 1968, more than 40 years after Carter's discovery, an anatomy professor x-rayed the mummy and revealed a sterling fact. Beneath the raisin, the cakes his chest, his breastbone and front rims are missing. Now some difficult words here. Intervening, occurring in the time between events. Intriguing, to arouse someone's curiosity. Startling, unexpected or surprising. In the past few decades, archaeology has changed as it now focuses on the details of life. Everything has been changed due to time and our flourishment, improvement in all the fields of life. So technology also has been improved and archaeology has changed as if it can now focus on the details of life and mysteries after death also. Earlier it was about focusing on the treasures. Now it uses more advanced medical technologies and tools for researchers. In past years that was just focusing on the treasures. Archaeology just focused on mainly the treasures related to past, but now it's possible due to the medical advanced medical science and technologies and tools for researchers. In 1968, an anatomy professor x-rayed the King Tut's mummy and revealed that the front limbs and the breast bones were missing. Due to the advancement of medical science, it was possible in 1968 to reveal that the Tut's mummy body has missing the front limb and the breast bone. Today's diagnostic imaging can be done with computer tomography or CT, by which hundreds of x-rays in cross sections are put together. Nowadays it's possible by CT scans also, like slices of bread, to create the three-dimensional virtual body images. What more would a CT scan reveal of Tut than the x-ray, and would it answer two of the biggest questions with lingering about him? How did he die and how old was he at the time of his death? King Tut's demise was a big event, even by royal standards. He was the last of his family's line and his funeral was the death rattle of dynasty. But the particulars of his passing away and its aftermath are unclear till now. What the author says here is it possible due to the advanced technologies and medical science and researchers that we have nowadays, not only the x-rays but multiple times more advanced technology of CT scan, where the body can have a three-dimensional virtual body effects with the slice of bread to create a three-dimensional virtual body effects and or x-rays we can say here. Is it possible to reveal the two unsolved questions here about the reason why the Tut died and what was the age when Tut died? It was unclear till now. Is it possible here? It's just a question raised by the author here. Computed, there are some meanings again, difficult meanings of a paragraph. Computed tomography, also called a CT scan. It is a three-dimensional scan of a body with the help of hundreds of x-rays in across sections together. Demise means death. Demise means death. Death rattle, a gurgling sound produced in the throat of a person who is about to die. Aftermath, after effects of an unpleasant event. So now again the explanation of this paragraph. Now with the advancement of technology, CT scan or computer tomography can give a virtual image of the whole body with the help of CT scan. You all have been familiar about the CT scan process. Nowadays it's very common in all the hospitals. King Tut's body would be scanned to find answers of the two big questions. What were the two big questions here? How he died and how old was he? How old was he at the time of death? The death was a shock to the royals also, as he was the last person of his family, and his funeral indicated the diminishment of his dynasty. That means end of his dynasty rule. However, what happened after his death is still not clear. It is not clear still now. So we will read in the next paragraph about it. The what is possible to reveal the mystery of the Tut's death, we will see in the next video. Thank you.